During the summers of 1976 and 1977, a young girl was sexually abused by her grandfather. "You hurt me. I had no one to talk to. Well, I spoke, but I was not heard. You tempted them with your money and paralyzed their actions. They would not protect me. I felt worthless, exposed, isolated, and confused. I was scared. I stopped trusting, and I learned how to manipulate my world. I learned to hide my feelings so that others would not know how I felt. I learned to be a good girl and to give to others to make them like me. I am a survivor, and I am strong. I refused to give in or to give up. I used this strength to help me cope. I built walls to protect me. I became a proficient mason. I continued to build until I was enclosed inside that wall, but I was all alone, and my life was not mine. I gave you too much power. During my obsessive building, I found I gave up living. I stopped participating in my life. I let others show me their way. They directed me. I continued to exist by tottering on random stepping stones, but I was stumbling mindlessly through life. These stones left bruises and hurt me when I fell. But I learned to balance and eventually came to realize that I can influence my life and alter its direction. I woke up and I stopped building. I started to breathe and I finally began to live. It was now time to give my life meaning, to stop being reflexive and to become intentional. It was time to uncover the me who was buried under years of skillfully positioned stonework. It was time to live. The trick was to find me without crushing me. I first asked myself, who is Eva, and what does she want? What is her passion? I am a caring and passionate woman. I color outside the box, and I see things in a unique way. I question, and I challenge. I have often been told that my spirit allows others to feel safe with me. I find solace in this gift, and I enjoy sharing in these moments. While trying to resolve my past, I have found my future, my direction in life. Through my perseverance, by refusing to hide and stay quiet, I have been actively living my passion all along. I just did not know it. The overwhelming feelings of hurt and disappointment have been inspirational in guiding me and sculpting my personality. My determination to conquer my past has created my dynamic direction. People that I have met along the way have been my encouragement and my inspiration. But my children have given me the strength to continue when I became tired and overwhelmed. Perhaps I am trying to fix what is broken. I know I could never go back and recreate my childhood. I am not supposed to. My healing would come from within me. It would transcend my pain and suffering and evolve into a lifelong quest to touch the lives of others in the many ways that I needed to be touched. My past happened for a reason. It is up to me to take that damaged child of the past, implode that hard, unforgiving wall of shame, and create a path that breaks the cycle of pain. But how can I accomplish this? What I have learned so far is this. Start small. Forget the rocks and boulders that I used to build that enormous wall around me. Rocks are hard and unforgiving and only serve to isolate me and prevent me from living. Instead, think of sand. Soft, gentle sand that surrounds your foot and molds to your step. It warms in the sun and soothes your tired feet. It leads to cleansing waters or guides you towards fruitful lands. It can be sculpted and will cradle you when you slip and fall. And so I started small. I started with children. I stepped into my role as one who nurtures children. Through my desire to be a mother, a nurse at a children's hospital, and now a volunteer at a homeless shelter for children, I have expanded my vocation. I have become exactly what the Great Spirit meant for me to be. By accepting my calling, I have come to peace with my past and broken the cycle of hatred. I have made a difference. My journey has motivated me to give to others and to encourage them to live their best life. I now cast off the hate and fear that I used to protect that little girl. I have broken down that wall. While I cannot forget or forgive, I can triumph over my past. I have blossomed into a healer for myself and others. Through my gentle way, let me spread a rainbow of love to those I meet along the way. May we all step out from behind our walls and leave a legacy of love for those who follow. May we forever dance in the sand, together, leaving nothing but footprints behind.
Best thing you ever done for me is to help me take my life less seriously. It's only life after all. Yeah. Well, darkness has a hunger that's insatiable, and lightness has a call that's hard to hear. And I wrap my fear around me like a blanket. I sail my ship of safety till I sank it. I'm crawling on your shores. I went to the doctor. I went to the mountains. I looked to the children. I drank from the fountains. There's more than one answer to these questions, pointing me in a crooked line. And the less I seek my source for some definitive, closer I am to find, yeah. Closer I am to find, yeah. And I went to see the doctor of philosophy with a poster of Rasputin and a beer down to his knee. He never did marry or see a big great movie. He graded my performance. He said he could see through me. I spent 4 years prostrate to the higher mind. Got my paper and I was free. And I went to the doctor. I went to the mountains. I looked to the children. I drank from the fountains. There's more than one answer to these questions, pointing me in a crooked line. And the less I seek my source for some definitive, closer I am to find. Twice as cloudy as I've been the night before. And I went in seeking clarity. I went to the doctor. I went to the mountains. I looked to the children. I drank from the fountain. Then we go to the doctor. We go to the mountains. We look to the children. We drink from the fountain. Yeah, we go to the Bible. We go. Yes, I seek my source for some definitive, closer I am to find.